Okay, so let's start our class with a prayer. Everybody please stand for our prayer. Okay, close your eyes, bow your heads, and let us ask for the guidance of our Lord.
Dear Lord, we thank you for the gift of life today. You allow us to have another day to praise you and see your glory. Thank you for the love and protection, especially this time of pandemic. Bless us, Father, with your wisdom as we begin our class. Help us to focus our hearts and minds on what we are about to learn. Inspire us by your Holy Spirit as we think and listen. Guide us by your eternal light as we discover more about the world around us. Lord, we thank you and let your will be done in our lives. We ask all this in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen.
Okay, so good afternoon, grade 4.
Good afternoon, teacher. Good afternoon, classmates. It's nice to see you today.
Okay, so before you settle down, let us have first our energizing dance. Okay, are you ready to be energized?
Yes.
Okay, so dance well. Everybody go.
Okay,
and
actually the verb goes
Okay, so we have discussed that one yesterday. So now, we're going to identify which from the same given sentence is active or passive, okay? The number one sentence. Everybody read.
The chef baked the cake.
Okay, what is the sentence?
Chef!
Okay, wants to answer, raise your hand. Okay, Chaylin.
Active.
Okay, active. Okay, the chef baked the cake. So how are we going to turn this one into passive? Yes?
The cake was baked by the chef.
Exactly. Very good. Okay, next. So that is after. How about the second sentence?
Teacher, I wasn't here yesterday.
Yeah, but I already discussed this one
when
you were here. Remember, I think last Friday. Oh, last Tuesday, right? Okay. So about the second sentence, Reese. How about the second sentence? Read and answer.
Passive.
Okay, if you want to answer, just stand. Stand and tell me your answer. Okay, that is?
Passive.
Okay, very good. That one is a passive. How about the third one? Yes, Edison?
Can I
drink water? Sure. Okay, make it quick. Yes? No, later after our class. Rina, you want to answer? The teacher explained the lesson. Active or passive?
Active.
Okay, let's check your answer. Okay, very good, Rina. And the next one is? Anybody wants to answer? Okay, Charles?
Passive.
Okay, can you please read and answer?
The house was built by them.
The house was built by them, and this is? Okay, very good. Okay, so now class, since all of you. Okay, please be quick. Okay, so now all you have to do, since we're done with our lesson with the active and passive, you have to guess the hero. Okay, I will just give here a describing words that will describe the hero, and all you have to do is just to guess. Who is that hero?
Okay.
Him, it is an Avenger.
Yes.
Okay. So, the number one is, he has a big cake.
Wait,
wait. He has a straw. He has a straw. Zooms through the sky. And lastly, S-shaped symbol on chest. Okay, let's check your answer. The correct answer is Superman.
Yeah.
Who among you loves Superman?
What?
Nobody loves Superman.
What?
How about the Edison? Oh, you don't like him. But some of the kids, other kids like Superman. We all have different favorites. Okay. Guess the hero. How about the next one? Black suit.
Oh, I think I know this.
Next one. Dark cake. Next one. Stands on tall buildings.
Wait.
And lastly, bad signal shining the night. Okay, very good. So that is Batman. Raise your hand if you love Batman.
I like Batman.
Only Edison and Charles. How about Denise? Okay, you love Batman also. Were you able to watch Batman?
No.
Not yet?
Batman is also in The Flash.
Okay. So next one, class. Here's the description. Bright red and blue suit.
I think I know this.
Swings between buildings.
Oh,
Quick and agile. And lastly, web design. Okay, let's check your answer if you got it right.
Come home.
Okay, very good. Okay, just do like this. Okay, that is Spider-Man. Come on, you love Spider-Man. Okay, how about the girls? Okay, that's fine. One more. Oh, this one is already given. Were you able to see that?
No.
The green man.
hook.
Hook.
It's
a hook.
It's kind of zombie.
Okay, so now class, I have a question. What do you notice about those words being used for you to guess the hero?
Super!
They are?
Describe.
Okay, they describe the hero, right? For you to guess the hero. So now, I have a question. What do we call to a part of speech that is used to describe the noun or a pronoun?
A verb
is an action word.
A subject.
What do we call to a part of speech that describes a noun or pronoun?
A subject.
Predictions.
A subject.
What do we call to the describing words? No. It's starting with letter A.
Adjective.
Okay, very good, Addison. Adjective. Okay. Everybody say adjective. Okay. Okay, so at the end of the lesson, you should be able to define what an adjective is. Next one, identify adjectives in a simple sentence. And the third one, you have to construct a sentence using adjectives. Is our objectives clear?
Yes.
Okay. So now, since we already talked about, since our topic today is adjective, when we say adjective, it is a part. Everybody please read.
An adjective is a part of speech that describes a noun or pronoun.
Okay, always remember, adjective describes. Okay? Again, adjective
describes
a noun or pronoun.
Okay, describes a noun or pronoun. Very good, great work. So now, since we already talked about adjective, we have your example sentence. Everybody please read.
The mountain stands
proudly. Okay, who among you already went to Balayog?
I also went there
too. Okay, so how was the experience in Balayog?
It's fun.
It's fun. Were you able to see the big fountains there?
Yeah.
The mountain area?
Yeah.
Okay, so there were so many activities that you can do in Balayog. Yeah, okay, yes.
There are
also
mountains.
Are called
building like that? I can go up.
Yeah.
Oh, there.
Okay, so that is what a Balayog is. Okay, so class, yes, please, want to tell something? Want to say something?
There are actually turtles on there.
Oh, yeah. We're able to see that one.
Yes!
The one, something.
Yes, a guy was like in the top.
Yeah?
It's a dog.
Oh, yes. You're right.
Yes, you're right.
Yeah. Okay, so that is where we can find the?
He's a native.
The Balayog. Yes, that's right. The native here in Palawan. Okay? So here, what is the bold word in the sentence? Okay, the bold, it describes the?
Balayog.
Okay, very good. It describes the?
Balayog.
Actually, class, the Balayog here, it is referring for a flower. Okay, a tree that bear a flower. Okay, we call it Balayog. Sometimes it's color pink. If you go to Balayog, I think they are now flowering. Some are flowering and you can able to see that color pink flower. Okay, so I hope you next time, Gabi, if you went there, hoping that if you go there rather, I hope you see the flower of the Balayog.
Is it like a cherry blossom?
Yeah, the cherry blossom exactly. Okay?
There's a lot of them in Japan.
Yeah, yes, Edison. Some are?
Blonde.
What do you mean?
Like
my
girlfriend,
I think. But maybe it's night, it's dark.
Teacher, I saw a blossom tree.
Oh.
Teacher, I saw a blossom tree at
the Lido. Ah, yes. Okay, Lido has also been. There were so many in Balayog, okay? So here, class, always remember this word called. It describes the Balayog. The next sentence. Read, everybody.
The
okay. Have you ever visited SMO? Okay. So what is the word that describes SM? Okay. Busy because yes.
What is SM stands for?
SM stands for supermall is that?
Supermarket.
Shopping mall.
A shopping mall. Okay.
Superman.
Okay, a shopping mall. Okay. Or a super mall.
Superman.
Okay. So I actually didn't know exactly what SM stands for, but as far as my friend, they call
supermarket.
SM stands for a supermarket or a super mall. Okay, or a super mega mall. But okay, about that, I'll just be updating you. Maybe I'll do a research about this. But thank you, Lance, for asking, okay? Okay, the next one. Everybody read.
The name of popular
Okay. Okay, so I expect that all of you already went to Baywalk. Okay, so. Place is not clean yet, so the rats will live there. So that's why we have to make it clean. Yes, want to say something?
I go there to I took a lap around the whole entire
Baywalk
with a bicycle.
Oh wow, yeah, actually there is a bicycle rental there, right?
Also I saw baby crabs in like, you know, the walk thing over here. I
mentioned
that there is
crabs. Oh yeah, okay. Okay, actually a shark, really? Oh, if that's so, wow. Because it's very rare if you will see some sharks there. Wow, you must be lucky enough. Okay, so here, going back to our lesson, what is the word that describes Baywalk?
Popular.
Okay, popular. Okay, so next class, since we already talked about hero, I hear a poem. And later, you will know who is that hero. Okay, everybody please read.
In a small town filled with bright light, lived a caring woman with a heart so bright.
Next.
She made louder. Superman, sorry, I think that harder.
Not like Batman. Protects us with a gentle, loving light. Let's see later.
Wait.
Okay.
She does not swing
like Spider-Man through the air.
But her warm arms catches her tender yards through
the Just read it out there.
But
her endless love is the strongest we've ever told. Last year.
A hero without cape or a mighty mask and a baby.
Okay, who is the hero in the story?
Mother! I said it!
Okay, very good, Edison. You got it so early. So that is the mother. Okay. So what are some of the qualities of the mother there? A mother is a... Did I hear because a mother is?
Love caring.
Loving.
Endless love.
Okay, a loving mother. What else?
She born us.
The mother born us. So what, based on the poem, what else are the describing words that will describe the mother? Okay, hugging your mother hugs you. What else? May we consider that your mother is caring, loving. What about hardworking?
Yeah.
Okay, hardworking. Okay, so now class, let's take note of this word. So now I have another question. Do you love your mother?
Yeah.
Okay, raise your hand if you love your mother. Can you please give a round of applause to your mother if you love them?
Give a clap if you love your mother. Okay. Okay, so how would you describe your mother? You're using your own describing word. Just one for each of you. Reese, how can you describe your mother?
Hardworking.
Hardworking.
Kind.
Kind. Lance, how would you describe your mother? Mami siya.
She is beautiful.
She is beautiful.
Caring.
Very caring. Rina. Charles, how would you describe your mother?
Loving.
How about you, Rina? Gabby?
Nice.
How about you, Edison? How would you describe your mother?
Gentle.
Gentle. Okay, very good, everybody. So, I can describe my mother as the loving mother.
The best
mother in the whole wide world. She is the best mom in the world. Okay, everybody, can you please say, my mom is the best mom in the world. Okay, so that's why I always love your mother, because our mother is doing everything for us, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so now, I have here a sentence. She is a hardworking and caring mother. Who wants to go in front and circle the adjectives? Okay, Charles, go in front. Just one only. Okay, faster. What is the adjective in the sentence? Okay, hard. Be quick. Assist. Okay. Oh, it's like a burger now. Okay, next we have hardworking. Who else? Shailene, you want to answer? Aside from hardworking. Okay. Spicy. Okay, very good. Okay, everybody, those are the describing words. What are they? The first one is?
Hardworking.
And?
Caring.
Okay, so those hardworking class and caring are the first type of adjective which we call descriptive adjective. Okay, what does descriptive adjective mean? It describes quality or kind. Okay, like for example, how we're going to describe the mother? The mother is hardworking and caring. Okay? So the next one here. I have another example, and who wants to answer? Reese. Okay, go in front and circle the descriptive adjective in the sentence.
How many are there?
Let's see how many. For strong love helps us every day. So it means the quality. It describes her. What describes her love? Which one of those words? Her strong love helps us every day. What describes her love?
Strong.
Okay, very good, Reese. So, everybody, what describes her love?
Strong.
Strong. Strong love. So this one, as long as it describes the quality or a kind of something, we call it? Okay, very good. So next class, we have, aside from descriptive adjectives, we have another adjective which we call it quantitative adjective. So do you have any idea about quantitative adjective?
Is the adjective the noun?
Okay, let's see. Okay, here's the definition. Okay. It describes the quantity or amount. For example, she made many cookies for the children. So what is the adjective here?
Many.
Okay, Edison, want to go in front? Which of the sentence describes quantity? Okay, that word many, right?
Yeah,
it describes how many cookies. Okay, next. How many cookies? Next, on this sentence. She gave us numerous hugs when we were sad. Rina. She gave us numerous hugs when we were sad. You want to answer, Edison?
I
could try Edison.
Charles.
Okay. Oh, is it Charles the one who answered? Oh, yeah. Charles, please.
You wanted to answer
it. Okay, later I'll call your name. Okay, what is the word there that describes a quantity or an amount? Here.
Mustard.
Charles. Okay. Okay, do you agree with Charles' answer?
Yes!
Okay, very good. So, it describes how many hugs? Numerous. Numerous hugs. Okay, countless hugs. Very good. That is a many, many hugs. A countless hugs. So next, yes, many or numerous, they are synonyms, Gabby. Thank you for raising that. Okay, so next, aside from quantitative, the first one again, we have descriptive. The second one, quantitative. And the third one is demonstrative. So what does demonstrative means? It's point out specific things. For example, this love she gives makes us feel. When we say class demonstrative, these are when you use to point things. That is a book. Those are bottles. So what is a demonstrative?
Is it like this?
Very good. This one.
I just said, is it like this?
Okay, so this. Okay, anybody, how about here the second sentence? Let's find out. And let's encircle the given demonstrative. It's Rina, what's your answer? Go in front and answer. Read and answer.
I already saw the answer to the second one. It's so easy.
Okay, very good. So those warm cooking smell delicious. Okay, can you, who among you wants to use demonstrative adjective in a sentence? Can you please give one? Can you please give one? Chai, yes, please.
This is great for classroom.
Okay, this is great for classroom. So the use of this, okay? Did you understand it now?
Yes.
Yes, you want to do something?
Those are my candy for Halloween.
Those are my candy for Halloween. Candies for Halloween. Okay, very good. The use of those. Right, please? Okay, so now let us have a group activity. So those three here in front will be group, and those four at the back will be group. So all you have to do, I will give you this piece. You will read this one and encircle all the adjectives. It can be demonstrative, descriptive, or quantitative. I will just give you only 2 minutes.
This is
for group two. Work with them, rather. And then this one. Read a one and encircle those. Please, you have to work with your groupmates. Make it simple.
This is our side.
Yes, okay. We will be having our activity adjective search. So given here the paper there at your group, you will be encircling all those adjectives. Do it silently. You have a question? Okay, you are going to encircle those adjectives. The first group has their own class and your group has your own class also. Okay?
What do you call this
one?
Adjective
search. Okay? Okay, Lance, you have to encircle your
group. Where is the group?
This one is for their group.
Now, sir,
they don't have any. This group one on. Okay?
Adjective.
Teacher,
are we going to do it
all? Yes,
all
of that.
The adjective
then. Edison, where is your adjective there? Okay. Last 1 minute.
Adjective only.
Adjective only. comes is an adjective or verb. Okay, once you're done, clap your hands. 10, 9, 8, 7. Okay, so now once you're done, arrange your chairs properly. Put them back in its position. Okay, who wants to present their answer first? Yes? Yes. Okay, so group two, since you're done first, come here in front all of you and read all your, and read the given paragraph and what are those words?
Smallest in the middle.
Okay, arrange your chairs, Edison. Your groupmates is about to present your answer. Okay, read first, and then after that, you're going to, it's already time.
Is it offered?
Okay, so arrange this one. Yeah. Go back to your seat. Okay, listen to the group one, or group two rather. Okay, read and give us the answer. Make it louder.
Baker Hill is a beautiful park with colorful gardens and delicious pastries. The peaceful atmosphere attracts many tourists who enjoy the fresh air and the scenic view of Puerto Princesa.
Okay, what are those adjectives? The first one is?
Beautiful.
Yes.
Colorful.
Okay.
Delicious.
Okay.
Peaceful.
Okay. Okay, very good. So a perfect 10 for group 2. Okay, group 1, let's see.
Teacher.
Yes, Paul.
Why are you having group 1 and group 2?
Yes, this is because we needed you to work together. Teacher. Group 1, go in front. Yes,
ma'am. Why are you having group 2?
Because this is for our activity.
Because you know we're having a what?
Because it's a group activity day. And you have to work and collaborate with
us. And is it a drill?
No, this is our activity, group activity.
And also, it's a drill.
Read and okay, I'll answer your question after this. Okay?
Can I go to the
restroom? Okay, wait. Okay, everybody please read and answer.
Edison.
Faster. Okay.
Smallest in the middle.
Smallest in the middle.
Faster. Make your voice loud. What are those adjectives?
Rich,
modern,
colorful,
spacious,
friendly, warm.
Okay, again, a perfect 10 for group 1. Very good. Okay, everybody, give yourself a clap because all of you are very good.
Teacher,
what's
the group?
Group stand, sorry. Okay, so next. Okay, now class, how would you describe your favorite food? Delicious.
Yummy.
Yummy. Okay, so now how do adjectives, when you talk about your day or describe something to a friend?
Kind.
How do adjectives help you when you talk to your friend or you talk about your day?
Friendly.
Yeah, friendly. How adjectives help you to talk about your day?
Because they tell you how you feel.
They tell you how you feel, or you go more into detail about how's your day all about.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
It's not just about the day, but you will say, it's a beautiful day.
It's a beautiful day.
It's a nice day, right?
Yeah.
So you become more detailed about describing your particular, about the particular day, right? Understand? Grade 4.
Yes.
Okay, next.
Super.
So now, guys, I have a question. What is the rule of an adjective in a sentence? It?
Noun and pronoun.
It the?
Describes.
The noun and?
Pronoun.
Very good. Okay, now let's have the quiz. Did you understand noun adjectives? Okay, so here class, in your quiz, the part one, all you have to do is to define what an adjective. The part two, you will go into underline that a given adjective in the sentence. And the third one, you're going to construct at least two sentences using an adjective. Okay? Please write your name on top. Write your name on top. Your name here, Charles. As well as you here. Lance here and
you,
Charlie. Okay, I will just give you only... Okay, let me take a look at the time first. Okay, just 4 minutes left to finish your quiz.
Mom, my turn.
Yes?
Is that the cheese
one? Okay, so what? Okay, so finish that one because you'll be submitting that after.
What's the adjective?
Something that describes. An hour discussion.
After quiz.
After a question, please rather it. We will check your paper. Okay? Okay, so. Okay, define what is an adjective. Okay, here.
The chapter is.
Okay. What do you think? The one that describes the school. Okay, make it quick. Last 3 minutes.
What do we do? Part three.
Part three, you're going to make a sentence. Think of any adjective that will. It's up to you. But you can make your own sentence also. Actually, you're supposed to make your own sentence here. Okay. Yes,
please.
Okay, here.
You
have to define what is an adjective.
Describe?
Yes.
Okay. Iris.
You have to define.
Teacher Iris.
Yes.
Why? When it's time not ready?
And not when yet. Let us wait for the bell ring. Okay? Okay, answer this one now.
Where's the bell? Where's the bell?
Okay, two sentences.
Oh, teacher, when it's time now, when you're going to hear the bell ring.
Yeah.
Okay, this, where is it, the bell ring?
Now it's not already time, okay?
Where?
I think the bell is there. The okay.
Where? The bell is.
Yeah, let us wait for the bell being before we end our class. Okay, yes. Okay, this one make it a sentence. A design. What about this one? The teacher is friendly. Is it the teacher? What describes the teacher? What describes the teacher? Oh. Okay. Okay, so Lance, encircle there the adjective in the sentence. Okay, last 2 minutes.
Okay,
very good. I just want to review your answer here. Remember the demonstrative and the other adjectives. What describes the noun? Okay, identify first the noun and then. Okay.
Eat.
Yes. Oh.
Even when it's passing our paper.
Festival.
If it's time not ready.
Yes. You have to submit that. You're done?
Or pass.
Okay, drink the water.
Or pass.
Okay, thank you, Edison.
Yeah. Or pass it.
Yeah, you have to pass it after.
Or submit.
Or submit. The same thing, that's. Okay?
Little
like acronym. Yeah. Okay, so write a sentence using a. Think of any adjective. Okay, Dance? Think of any adjective wherein. Okay, so the bell rings. Okay, so please submit your paper now. Submit your paper now.
And then why not automatically
round? Yeah, because it's already time. Because it settled that one and the opposite.
And why just round out of that one?
Yeah, it needs to.
Who's that?
Okay, so.
I'm good.
let's check this tomorrow and let's finish this before we start to another topic. Okay, so thank you very much for listening, grade 4. Goodbye, everybody.
Goodbye.